Now we started to train the dog at around 3 months old. It takes 6 to 9 months to fully train them. So around that 12 to 15 months fully trained, fully grown, and ready to start their working career. And they'll work right through to they're 8, 10, possibly even 12 years old, just depending on the dog. At which time then we retire them back to the homestead. Back, the boy here. There we go, we've got some movement there. Yeah, slowly, slowly. There we go. Now, yeah, folks, our paddock dogs, they don't push the sheep quite as hard as the yard and the shed dogs do. But persistence, we get them here eventually.
My goodness.
Now these are our merino sheep, these are our wool sheep in Australia. We have around 80 million sheep at the moment. Now let me show you a couple of those directional commands for the dog. Firstly, we're going to go anti-clockwise, so around me first. Around me, around the sheep, and stop. Now back the other way. Around the sheep, around me. And stop. So these are just some of the basic commands we need to teach the dog so they can come out and help us move sheep. So we're left and right, sit and stay. We can also ask him to come closer to the sheep, bring them to me, walk up. Walk up, Hunter, walk up. We can also ask him to back away from the sheep, give them more room so they'll stay quite happily where they are. So they're just the basic commands. Now we're going to take him and put him through the gap in the fence, under the tank and over the bridge. If he gets it right, please do give him a nice big clap. He does understand and he's doing a good job. Lay down. Lay down.
Kazim, you know why you wanted to see boy? Check the bone inside. Maybe even I guess one of it. What is it?
Remember, he's commanding him.
Mm-hmm. All right, folks, straight through, nicely done. Folks, we've done the paddock work now. Come on, Hunter. Hunter.
There's always been sheep as long as there's been civilization. Some sheep shed their wool, but most sheep just keep growing wool, so they have to be shorn at least every 12 months. So originally, we shore all the sheep with blades or shears. And it was always hard work, and you could never get real close to the skin. And it was all physical, because you had to keep pushing and snipping at the same time. So a good day's work in our merino sheep was probably 60 to 80 sheep when we were shearing with those. If there's any English people here, they can relate to the name Wolseley, named for Frederick Wolseley, who invented the Wolseley car, also invented our very first shearing machine. The original motor was driven by steam, and that was the width we shore with. Now, they found very quickly that the shearer could get closer to the skin, and he could also shear more sheep with it. So the tallies came from 60 or 80 a day, up to 120, up to 150 a day. So that was our progress. In the 1980s, we adopted what we call a New Zealand comb, a wider comb again, and that's the one I'll use today. We did have, I was sharing at the time, there was a little bit of industrial trouble. If anyone wants to know the full story, do come and talk to me after the show and we'll talk about that. But that's the one I'm using today. A couple of things you must do when you learn to shear. It probably takes you the best part of 3 to 6 months to learn to shear properly. And you're always learning even in years later. But you must learn to use the handpiece and get down onto the skin. Now, the Merino sheep particularly have soft skin, and we take every care never to cut them. But occasionally you might see the tiniest of nicks, and we treat them straight away. There's probably more nicks when I shave myself than I do with the sheep. So that's probably the hard, is you learn to get onto the skin, and then the hardest part is holding it with your legs. You must be able to manoeuvre the sheep so they're comfortable, and that we can move them around and shear the wool off in one piece. So that's the hardest part to learn. They are an extremely strong animal, and in one working day, we don't skite about it, but it's just such a hard job that in one working 8-hour day, we use the same amount of energy as a marathon runner, and we do it 5 days a week. So it is probably one of the last very, very hard jobs. We get paid $2.80 for every sheep we shear, and that's the way the more you shear, the more you get paid. A good shearer in Merino sheep can shear up to 200 sheep a day or more. The world record is over 500. The person was shearing the sheep in under a minute. Believe me, I won't be shearing in under a minute. It'll take me probably 4 or 5 minutes. So that is what young men are capable of doing. It is there are people compete all around the world. It is a very competitive thing in the shearing industry. If you get 10 shearers in a row, you can imagine there's a little bit of testosterone flying, and there is prestige involved with the fastest shearer. So I'm going to go up, and we'll shear a Merino sheep. The first thing I've got to do is select one and tip it over. Now, the way it's been designed to do, you would think with all our technology that there would be better ways, but believe me, millions and millions of dollars of research money has been put into trying to shear a sheep. Robots, chemicals, all sorts of things, but still today we shear them exactly like this. It is the best for the sheep and best for us. So I'll talk you through it as I go. I've got to get the sheep and tip it over. It doesn't look that graceful for the sheep. It is scientifically designed. Now, the underneath part of the sheep is probably the worst wool on the sheep because they lie down at night. It's called the belly wool. It comes off first. So what you'll see me do is work, take the belly wool off, throw it aside, and I'll start to work on the rest of the sheep. One thing I did in general is that we do have what we call a back swing. Now, also invented in the 1980s, it does take 50 to 60% of the weight off your lower back and legs. Today I just won't use it just for this one, but if I was shearing more than one, I certainly would be. Now I have complete control over the sheep with my legs and left hand.
Oh my god.
Okay, so we start on the belly wool. What we call stinging on the belly at the moment. We have a lot of rain here in Brisbane, and with the rain comes the discoloration of the wool. So this belly wool is probably the worst bit of wool on the sheep. Okay, that's taken away. We quickly clean up around the leg areas. Every part of the sheep must be sure. Once we get to this area, you can see that the white wool will start to appear. Our sheep must be sure every 12 months. This one for the demonstration has got much shorter wool than 12 months. Okay, haircut time. This is what we call the neck area of the sheep. Very hard when you're learning because you are underneath the wool. You can't always see where you go.
for you.
Okay, we've got complete control over that sheep. We're just about to turn the sheep and we're going to turn the wrong way. And we lay the back, the sheep completely on its back. Once again, evenly balanced and comfortable. And the sheep from the back of the sheep right through to the front. Now you can see that the sheep is not distressed in any way. Now the sheep have a substance in their wool called lanolin. Some of the ladies might know about lanolin. We have a tub of it at the top of the steps if you are wrapping it too tight on your hands. But whenever I shear and whenever we handle work, our hands are always soft. It is also a marvellous healing agent, and any little cuts that are on the sheep or wool are healed very quickly because of that lanolin. They do it, they can kick, they can object if they want to, but it's our job as a shearer to keep the master in that nice and quiet. Remember, we're doing it for $2.80. If anyone would like a haircut after the show, they're welcome. Never had any tigers yet. Okay, that's the way we shear our sheep. Okay, now my job is not finished here today, but if I was a shearer I'd be straight back in and start another one. But in every shed there's at least one shed, one staff on the ground to take the wool away from the shear. So what you do is gather it up into a ball. And it must go onto that table and be presented so we can handle it. So we throw it like a blanket onto a bed. Spreads out on that table. And you can see the dirt on the back of the sheep. That's because of the lanolin. It washes out in the middle. Now, extremely greasy, this one. You can feel the grease just almost dripping off it. That's lanolin. It's a great product. So what we're going to do is ask you to come in and have a look at the sheep, the wool, and we're going to have this big merino ram over there with the dog. If you've got any questions, please ask Jeff or myself, because we've been around the sheep and the shearing sheds all our life. Thank you for coming to our show. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day here. Thank you very much.